is a tub of something. Oh, that'll be about 100 litres worth of herbicide, possibly. There we are. I'd ended up with the steering wheel a little off center. Took me a while to figure out which way I should be turning it. There we go. Probably do all of this from the cab. So, unfold. Turn on. I'm not, but I probably could do it. Just I want to see the first of the hay come out. I think at the moment we have a lot of hay. I'm not sure. We'll have to check on the sheep, see how much hay they need for a year. But I think I bought 6 bales, and we've used maybe 2 of them. Too bad a turn there. Seem to be managing keeping the pickup online, but that's a good deal. Actually straining the capabilities of this tractor. So I might not be able to use a mid-sized baler or mid-sized tractor on this baler with the steepness of these hills. Some of the lower fields near the main road we can probably get away with a mid-size, but tractor is struggling at times. Right about now, we're down to 8 miles an hour. And we're packing almost 400 horsepower here. Oh, you didn't just drop there, did you? May need to look for a bumper weight for when we're baling. We use one on raw folds, usually on the wrapper. Or the collection wagon, just to push the bales aside. But it does come in handy at times. Now also, since we're coming in late in the evening now, I'm probably going to unload the bales into one of the sheds and then stack them tomorrow morning. Rather than trying to get them unloaded and stacked tonight. We'll put the equipment away though. I think. Well, yeah, we'll put the equipment away. If we need it tomorrow, we need it tomorrow. So, from the engine noise, we are straining a little. But we are keeping up. The operating speed, so it's not too bad a thing. But, and grab this on the edge. Most of the outer headland, not missing too much. The decisions on how much to keep, how much to sell tomorrow. How much to keep and how much to sell will be made tomorrow. When it comes to the stacking. Okay. Swing this one wide. Go from the inside. It might be easier at this point. Oops. Maybe there's some there. Okay. Miss a row, do a row. And we already missed the other row, so. So, much like Lawfolds, this map has hills and power requirements way beyond what would normally be recommended for our field equipment. For this next bit though. So we'll take that short row on the right, and then the row on our current left is one that takes us straight back to the top of the field again. Hay in this field. I don't recall if it was fully fertilized or not. Let's do that rope. Is actually our first grass cut of the year, which happened early summer. I like to do it late spring if I can, normally. So we may. This is definitely a point where we can do. Hay as a cut. I'm thinking anything earlier because of the dew on the ground. We won't be baling hay in spring. And we probably also won't be baling hay in fall. But if this cut is sufficient for what our sheep need for an entire year, I'm gonna say everything else we cut this year will be silage, because we are gonna need the money and we're gonna want the digestate next year. So we have to start thinking about that now. And we have this field and number six are full grass fields. So they will be they will be quite high yield, all things considered. Okay, we need 2,300, 1,700 litres of straw hay thing, yellow stuff goes into bales. Honestly, don't think there's that much left in this field. $700, I still really not sure. And over this side, see if it's here. There's a bit of a little bit there. For 3,000 still. Nah, we'd have nowhere near another 1,000 litres on this field, so. Some load. Now we can fold it. This tractor could do it with a maintenance run. So again, I'll put the baler at the bottom of the yard. We'll grab the auto stacker. Try not to tip the tractor over. Already. Hopefully it doesn't take too long to collect all the bales. So they need 46,000 litres. Call it 47. 12 bales. Yeah. So one auto load trailer's 14. We will be grabbing. We'll drop the full trailer. We'll sell any other full trailers. Well, we'll see. We're definitely keeping one full trailer. But then after that, we may be selling most of the rest. I think it depends. If I end up with one or two left after collecting full trailers, then we'll probably keep the one or two. Okay. But otherwise, if it's more than a few, we'll sell any after the first full trailer. So, I'm thinking about it, we've still got the original hay that we bought from the store. We still have, I think, about 4 or 5 bales. This is not prototypical for the UK or Europe, since this pickup trailer is actually Canadian. But that was enough. Okay, that's 10. Last one. No, I haven't counted, but more than a full trailer, but not by much. So down the road to the yard. In on the second door here. The stack bales are over there. So I'll be able to reverse that in here and then use the limiter to stack over there. Get this in the hard way. Uh, that would probably be a no. Oh yeah. However, an escape path there. Work. Right. Should just hitch up about 45 degrees. And then slide off of the back. That. A row of bales that a tractor can handle. If I had a telehandler, I may have got the stacker, the full upright stacker. So I think these sheds are high enough that we could get a stack of 16, or two double stack of 8 inside without fouling the roof. Unfortunately, we don't have a telehandler. Not at this stage, although now we do have the option of buying the class Scorpion, because the latest patch allows you to refuel it. So yay for that. Okay, this load I'm just going to sell. Probably in our yard. May take a look, see what the relative prices are. I don't think it says. Don't think it says. It's a wild guess. Eeny, meeny, miny. That one probably. So biogas plant will take them. And these don't. Well, those just say they're worth zero because the price they're giving there is for loose.